All right, man, I am in New Jersey for my first time ever. Decided to chase the striper migration. That big body of fresh migratory stripers has not entered Rhode Island yet, or if it has, I haven't seen them. I have absolutely zero experience fishing New Jersey. This is gonna be a big learning curve for me. But a big shout out to Jack. We both follow each other on Instagram, and he reached out. I was like, hey man, if you wanna fish Jersey, here's a good place to try. So kind of pointed me in the right direction. I put his Instagram handle in the video description. Really cool dude, hardcore kayak fisherman for sure. But yeah, again, I have no experience fishing Jersey, so I'm just gonna cover a lot of water and try and figure this place out and see if a blind squirrel can get a nut. So see if we can catch some stripers, huh? We want migratory fish, stripers with lice. That's what we're looking for. Hopefully a slob, but I'll take anything. Just wanna get the skunk out of the way.
It's a beautiful morning. I'm just kinda trying to figure out this area. Well, I marked a few fish on the side scan. The water's 45 degrees. These fish are still probably sluggish. I wanna throw a small matio out. Small little soft plastic presentation, and I'm just gonna slow troll it, see what I can mark. And if I start marking a lot of stuff on the side scan, like right now, not really a lot, but if I start marking fish, then I'll throw a cast at them. Right now I gotta get the skunk out of the boat. And to really optimize my chances, I'm also gonna throw out this small blue X-wrap, which is really, I do pretty well for it for holdovers when the water is cold. So I'll have two water columns covered. I got deep cover with the tube, and I got upper covered with the X-wrap. It's just, I typically don't like trolling with two lines because you hook up with one and the other one sometimes gets wrapped up, but really want to get the skunk out of the boat, so it's a risk I'm willing to take. Hooked up, baby, on the troll. Oh man, that was a lot of ground I had to cover. I don't think this is anything big, but that's all right. This is my first Jersey bass. Yes, sir. What a momentous day. Honestly, I think it grew a little bit, man. Okay. Let me take my time with her. Don't want to lose this fish. All right. Dude, this fish might have grew a little bit. That's not bad for the my first Jersey bass. Thought it'd be a little bigger. I don't know, I'm half asleep right now. I don't know what I'm trying to say. Nice, man. Hey, we'll take that. First Jersey bass. Not bad, honestly. Maybe, I don't know, 25, 26 inches. It's got some lice on its tail. That's a migratory fish. Take that all day. All right, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Blue X-wrap going back out. Make sure everything's good. Oh man, that's my first migratory fish of the season. That wasn't no holdover. That thing had lice on it. I'm telling you, man, that blue X-wrap is killer for waters 45 degrees. Well, you're not gonna believe this. I'm tight on a fish right now during a huge tangle up. This is why. Oh man, which line? So this line has a fish on it right now. No, this one doesn't. This line has a fish on it. This is a utter freaking disaster, bro. This is terrible. Now I'm on my rudder. Oh my god. Dude, this is a cluster. If I land this fish, it's gonna be a miracle. All right, let's get off my rudder. All right, I'm off my rudder. Oh man, welcome to Jersey, Johnny. I cannot believe it. I stopped, oh man. I stopped to like clear this line clutter up and I picked up a fish. There he is. I can't believe I landed that fish. Maybe I gotta slow my troll down or something. Look at that. This is gonna be a disaster to clean up, but here he is, fish number two. He's got lice on his tail right there. He's migratory. I don't know how I landed them during that disaster or even hooked them. All right, I'm a mess. Bye.
All right, well, that was a total freaking disaster. So basically, it's been a really slow morning. That was just my second fish, but after hours and hours and hours of fishing, this current is ripping right now. Like, I am barely making any headway. So anyways, I had two lines out and I wasn't really moving fast. I'm like, screw it, I'll bring the lines in. When I did that, the lines wrapped up on each other. Like I said, I don't like trolling two lines. And as I was fixing, getting the lure off the one line, I felt with my hand on the other line, a striper hit it and get hooked. And then that whole debacle ensued. Although I was able to get that fish in pretty fast. If that was a big fish, I probably would have been screwed, but I was a little schooly. So I think this is the end of my morning session. I gotta go back. I gotta eat and just catch my breath, but I'm hoping it's, I had to take the dry suit off. I'm burning up. It's like pretty much 70 degrees out right now. I'm hoping this really, really warm weather warms the water up, pushes more fish in, and gets some chewing. Because I marked for all the fish I marked, granted it was sporadic, I only caught two, which is surprising. I really just don't think they're chewing yet. So anyways, I'm tired. I'll see you guys this afternoon. All right, well, I'm out here later in the day. I'm gonna actually do a little night fishing as well. I'm hoping the water is at, let me show you here. The water's at 50 degrees. It was 46 degrees this morning when I launched. Obviously, this is the surface temperature. Had a couple guys tip me off and be like, hey man, even though it was a slow morning, you should come back at sunset / nighttime, try and get some bigger bass that might push in. So that's my goal. I'm gonna throw out this big old blurple, which is black and purple. Ah, beautiful, some nice rain. Yeah, I know. Ah, freaking osprey is not happy with me. I got a little too close to his home. It's him flying away.
He's Jeffrey. Got a couple mocks here. Come on. Come on. Right side too. Maybe I just stink. Ah, finally hooked up, man. Oh my goodness, that took a while. I freaking suck, man. I was trying to horse him in like a knucklehead. Damn it. I don't think that was a total mo- I saw its tail. I would say that's probably would have been the biggest fish I caught of the trip, but fuck. I'm gonna go a little further down and then I'm gonna let the current bring me back to my night fishing grounds. Oh, I'm starting to mark them a little thicker on the down scan. Again, not like breathtakingly huge marks, but they're down deep. They're hugging at 30 feet, which is why I've kind of switched over to this pretty heavy Savage Eel. Ooh, is that a hit or is that just skipping bottom? No, I think I'm getting whacked again. Come on, you gotta take it, my friend. You gotta take it. Oh, it's got waxed. Come on. A little love tap. Oh, here we go. On. Pain. Amateur hour. I should have just pedaled that hook set. I got too excited. Hooked up. Something minuscule. What do we got? Striper. Not quite the one I'm looking for, but it's a fish. There he goes.
All right, now that I'm rested, just wanted to recap the rest of that night trip and my day one of fishing in Jersey in general. The bite did get better that night, but it was all fish of that size. They're all schoolie bass. I think I landed three more schoolies, all literally pretty much that exact same size. And at that point, it was pitch dark, and I was kind of reserving filming and like flashing my light for the big fish. I kind of set like, hey, the next fish is going to be the big fish on camera. And that big fish, unfortunately, did not come. New Jersey is a brand new area to me. I've never hung out here socially, and I've certainly never fished here. So am I happy that I was able to go to a new spot, figure it out, and find some striped bass? Absolutely. That was a big goal of mine. Was step one was to catch fish, you know? There's something definitely satisfying about launching in just like a totally brand new area
and, you know, just over a couple hours figure it out and finding some fish. That being said, I was really hoping on day one, with the amount of hours I put in both in the morning session and a long night session, that I'd come out with a big bass. And unfortunately, I failed on that mission. And you know, a lot of this was user error. I had a couple instances at night where I was marking bigger marks at like 30 feet and was getting my artificial down there and messed up like 3 hook sets. The fish I lost at the kayak probably would have been the biggest fish of the trip. Granted, it wasn't a monster, but it would have been probably at least a slot fish. So I made a lot of mistakes on my end. Another contributing factor, I think I was a tad early before the big primetime spring run in New Jersey. I was there on April 8th, and the water temperatures in the Raritan when I launched in the morning was 46, maybe 47 degrees. That is some cold water, man. That being said, my first day in New Jersey was a blast. I did a lot of fishing and I found some stripers, man. I made it a goal this year to travel more and to fish new waters. And there's something to be said about just launching into a totally unknown area and figuring out. That's something that over the years in Rhode Island, I've kind of lost. Just kind of fishing the same areas over and over and over again. So to do that down in Jersey was a blast. And honestly, might take another crack at it in a couple of weeks, and I'll definitely head back down there for the fall run. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed day one of my Jersey fiesta. I got one more morning where I can fish, and then I gotta head back to Rhode Island, and then the season will begin here. So stay tuned.